Dear student of class 10th, in the chapter Light, Reflection and Refraction, we have studied about the reflection of the light and about the refraction of the light. So what happens in the reflection? It is, the light is reflected back to the same medium. It is not going across the medium. You are aware of it. Like light is reflected from the glass, because one side is reflecting, other is polished surface. Now in case of the refraction of the light from one medium, solid, liquid, gas, it goes from one medium to another medium and it changes its speed and direction. You are aware of it in the refraction of the light. So how the light refracts through the glass, transparent glass, like lenses. So spherical lenses we will discuss today, how the light changes its direction in case of the spherical lenses. So how many types of the spherical lenses are there? Are you aware of it? Yes, there are two types of the spherical lenses, that is concave and convex. Okay, depending upon the design of the lens, so it is specially designed, special cut of the glass to make the lenses. Here concave lens and convex lens, what will be the shape of the lenses? This is convex lens and concave lens we show like this. Okay, so this is called concave. So what is this point? It's called optic center. And similarly here for the convex lens, this is the optic center, and this is the line. This line is called principal axis, as you are aware. In case of the spherical mirrors we have studied about. Similarly here in case of the lenses, this is called principal axis. Now here, how many focus will be there, how many center of curvature we can see? So two. So in case of the both of the lenses, we will find that two center of the curvature and two focuses. What is the other name of the concave lens? Can you tell? Concave lens is also called diverging lens, and convex lens is also called converging lens. Why it is called so? Because the light after passing through it meets. Okay, that's why it is called converging lens, because it converges at point at focus. Similarly here in case of the concave lens, it is also called diverging lens, because the light after passing through it refracts and diverges. All of you are aware that when light goes from rarer to denser medium, it bends towards the normal, and it goes from denser to rarer, it moves away the normal. The same principle is also applied in case of the lens also. So when air, from air to glass, rarer to denser, it bends toward the normal, and it goes from glass to lens to outside the air, then it will move away the normal. That's why the ray diagram is like that also. Okay, let us see one by one. So here one thing you will notice that all the diagrams and the rules, as you have studied in case of the spherical mirrors, will be applicable similar to that in case of the lenses. So it will be very easier for you to understand in case of the lens, as you have studied in case of the mirrors. So you will find here that the convex lens will be similar to that of concave mirror. Okay, all those ray diagram, recall it, what you have studied in case of the spherical mirrors, concave mirror will be applicable to the convex lens. Similarly for the convex mirror, what you studied about the ray diagram and the rules and where the object was placed, all these things will be applicable in case of the concave lens also. So it will be very easy for you. Let us see. So there are, we will discuss in this that spherical lenses, we have seen this. Now we will see what are the principal focus, where are center of curvature and the focus. Let us see. So in case of the lens, for example, we are taking this convex. This is convex lens, all of you can see. So this point is called optic center, OPTIC, optic center. It is similar to the center of curvature. There the ray was passing without any deviation. So optic center is a point where the ray passes without any change in the direction. It will cross and go in the same straight line. Okay, and this is the line which is joining. This is called principal axis, as you are aware of it. So this will be the center. Similarly here, both side, this will be the center. So this is first center of curvature, this is second center of curvature. Okay, similarly focus, this is the first focus F1 and this is the other focus F2. So other name of C1 is 2F1, similarly other name of C2 is 2F2. One thing you have to keep your mind, that in case of the convex lens, focus always lies on the right hand side, it is always positive. Focus is always positive in case of the convex lens, and in case of the concave lens it is always negative. So here this is the number line, you are aware of the x-axis. Here left side is negative and right side is positive, you are aware of it. So where will you focus, left side or right side? Right side. So this is the principal focus. So principal focus, is it clear? In case of the convex lens, it is on the right hand side because it is positive. So always the length, focal length, which is distance from the optic center to the focus, will be positive. Whenever in the numerical, when you will do, you have to put positive sign, always keep positive sign. Okay, in case of the convex lens. However, in case of the concave lens, you will put minus sign even if it is not given in the question. I hope it is clear to you. Okay, so this is the case of the convex lens. This is principal focus. So all the ray which is passing parallel to principal axis will pass through the focus. So these rules for the ray diagram, today we will discuss this, so that next time later on you will able to draw the ray diagram for the image formation when the object is placed from infinity to beyond C, at C, between C and F, at F and between F and optic center, similar to the case of the concave mirror that you have done. So we will apply same for the convex lens here. So this is clear to you, the diagram, and the this is the principal focus. So what is the first rule? We will now apply the rules here. Okay, so any ray passing parallel to the principal axis, this is principal axis and this ray is passing parallel, it will go there to the focus, passes through the focus, so it will cross the lens, across the lens. Okay, it is refracting. We have studied about the refraction of the light. So light is going inside the lens and it is going out of the lens, it is refracts and it passes through the focus. So this is the rule. Now what is the other rule? Just reverse of this. Okay, when any ray will pass through the focus, it will become parallel to the principal axis, right? So any ray, for example, this is the ray which is passing through the focus, this is focus. So what will happen? It will become parallel to the principal axis. This becomes parallel to the principal axis. You can refer figure 10.3 to 10.15 of your NCERT textbook, the same you will find there, and how it is there I am clarifying you. Okay, so this is the ray diagram. Before that you will know the rule, this is the rule. So this is second rule. Okay, first was when ray passing parallel to principal axis passes through the focus, and this is the second, when it passes through the focus it will become parallel to the principal axis. Now the third rule, that any ray which is passing through the optic center will be passing without any deviation, without any change in its path. So in case of the spherical lenses, when any ray will pass through the optic center, so here you can see that this is the F1, this is the F2, and so third rule, what it says, 1, 2, 3, three rules are there. You can apply the third one, that any ray which is passing through the optic center, so like this is the ray which is passing through the optic center of the lens, it will pass in the same straight line without any deviation. So this is the third rule, I hope it is clear, all the three rules in case of the convex lens. Okay. Now, we will see in case of the concave lens. So, this is the diagram for concave lens. So, here you can see the two cut surface, it is also called double concave lens as well. Okay, so what is this point? Optic center, and what is this line called? Principal axis, correct. So this is O, and here you will find that so this is called double concave lens also, because two cut surfaces are there. So like this is the imaginary circle on both the sides. So this will be the center of this on both side. So you have to mark equal distances, whatever you are imagining. So according to that, without measuring it by scale also, if you are pointing this C, so it should be similar equal distance like here. So this is the first center of curvature, this is second center of curvature, C1, C2. Midpoint of this will be called focus, F1, this is F2. Okay, what is the other name of C1? 2F1 is also called 2F1. Similarly, what is the other name of C2? 2F2. Why it is called so? Because it is just double of the focal length. This is the radius, you are aware of it. So R for radius of curvature, small f is the focal length, distance up to focus. So in case of the concave lens, focus always lies on the left hand side. So this is the principal focus in case of the concave lens. So, and focal length will be always negative. When in the numerical focal length is given, for example 20 centimeter, so you will put minus sign here, okay, by yourself. So always keep this in your mind, because focus lies on the left hand side and it is always negative in case of the concave lens. I hope it is clear to you. So here also we will apply the rule. So this is the principal focus in case of the concave lens. Now, what are the rules? First one, all the ray passing parallel to the principal axis passes through the focus. So any ray which is passing parallel, we will draw here. So this is the ray, for example, which is passing parallel to the principal axis. This is principal axis. So any ray which is going, what will happen? It will refract, it will bend towards or away the normal. When it is going from denser to rarer, it will go away the normal. So that also we can find here, that it will be going away the normal. So it is passing through the focus, so this is the focus and it will be diverged. So this ray in the same line, you will proceed it like this and you will find that the ray is diverging. Okay. So this is the first rule in case of the concave lens. Now let us see the other one, which is already the ray is passing through the focus, it will become parallel to the principal axis. So let us do the other one. So here the ray is passing to the focus, like this is the ray which is going to the focus. Okay, what will happen to this ray which is passing towards the focus? It will become parallel to the principal axis. So after it, it will become parallel to the principal axis. So like this, second rule you can apply. This rule will be very much helpful when you will draw the ray diagram for image formation, when the object will be kept on the left hand side. Always you will use the new Cartesian sign convention, as you have studied in the case of the spherical mirrors, similar to that. Okay, after that, what is the third rule? Similar to the case of the convex lens, that any ray passes through the optic center, passes without any deviation, without change in the path. So the same you will apply here in case of the concave lens also, similar to this, that of the convex lens. The third rule, what is that? any ray which is passing through the optic center will be passing without any deviation. So let us draw like this. For example, this is the ray which is passing through the optic center. It will pass without any deviation, without any change. It may be from any direction, from here it is going, again we will apply the same, okay, from any direction which is going through the optic center from this point, it will passing through the same straight line without any deviation. So these rule will be very much helpful for you for the image formation by the lenses. So I hope it is clear to you. Okay, and focal length we have discussed that it will be negative in case of this concave lens. All right, I hope it is clear to you. Hope you are enjoying this. Okay, thank you very much.